ぜひレイドライザーを一家に一つご検討ください。
Hey guys, welcome to the 78th episode of the Soda Pop Podcast. As always, I'm your host, Frozen Stratos. Here with me today we have...
Josh.
Thanks to Soto Gaim, we can have Melon Bowl 2021. Woo!
You know what? That gets me hard, 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 hard!
That was the alternate opening I was going to use.
No, we knew it was going to happen.
Oh, of course, yeah. With all this implementation, how could you not get hard?
You will be blown away by 0-1.
You will be slurping by 0-1. I don't know what I'm going to have as the title yet, but it's definitely between implementation, and slurping, ..
I do really like implementation.
Yeah! And they've got quotes around all of it. But yeah, hey, if you didn't know, this is a Soto podcast. We talk about toys here.
That's right. And
there's a lot of news to discuss, even outside of our typical blog sphere, because the calendar updated with some new dates for certain items, some updates that sort of got squashed by this post, but the main thing to come out of it is actually some Ultraman news, like, for once. And it feels like... Huh?
I said, surprise.
Oh, okay. Sometimes you make that sound when a disconnect happens, and I'm like, oh no. But yeah, Ultraman. It's not dead. Shoto Ultraman is not dead. It comes back in March. And we have, I don't know, like, it's not what you expect, I guess. We don't have any newer characters. Just more of the same old people.
Let's kind of see. Like Shoto.
March of next... Pretty much, yeah. I mean, that is Shoto's MO. This is Shoto, excuse me.
Yeah.
It is Ultraman Nexus Genes. Is that Genesis?
Junis or something, and then yeah.
Evil Taiga. That was pretty blunt. Ultraman Jack. Gudon. And an expanded part set. The expanded part set comes actually with, like, an extra face for the monster in this, and then, like, a neat little shield, and then also you got your zappy zaps, the pew pew, you know, with the hand.
Ah, yes, very technical.
You make it vertical.
I like the.
Wow. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I just understood what you were saying, so that took a minute. But yeah, now I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
thank you for explaining it.
So yeah, you're welcome. So I know there are a lot of people you know, who are still loving Shoto Ultraman, so I'm glad that this line isn't dead. It's just it always feels like this line is on life support.
Yeah, it's like it's a line that, like, I always kind of forget exists, and now that I'm getting into Ultraman, I'm slowly considering it, but then, like, you know, like you said, it seems like it's barely here. And nothing really recent.
Yeah, and it scales with, like, nothing but itself.
True.
Unfortunately. I mean, there is a lot of support for it. Like, you do have all the little, I think they came with...
Like, little buildings or whatever.
Buildings or something at some point.
Yeah, those always look really cool. To be honest, those would be even great just to have for, like, Mini-Plot or something.
I do wonder, there was a line, and I think it got localized to the U.S., like, a line of Godzilla figures that, they're basically, like, the shrunken down Safubi figures. I think they were re-releases, but they had, I think, QR codes or a link to, PDFs you could print out, cut out, like, little buildings for them to, like,
oh, that's cool.
Be in. Yeah. I love the idea of paper craft upgrade kits and or play sets.
Oh yeah, for sure.
If Soto could do something like that as well, that would be awesome. Like, give us some really high res images of, like, I've always wanted to do the build cafe. One of those.
Very specific saying like that are good. I was also thinking, you know, that it's Toei. They could easily just, like, kind of do some double duty. Like, here's all the filming locations for Sentai and Rider.
Oh, that would be really neat.
I love that.
But I mean, how hard would it be to make those, like, white pillars connected by a single, like, rectangle? I'm pretty sure we could knock that out in a few seconds and print it, but you know what? I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you, Bandai. You give it to me.
And also, I thought you were talking to me.
Make your blog posts available, too.
What was that, Josh?
They should make the blog post sets available, too.
They should. You know what? Like, I am all for just paper craft settings.
Yeah.
If they've got them. So that's something I'd really like to see.
Enter
the
survey.
Back and, like... That's true. Fill out the survey. I need to find the link again to the Godzilla post. I think it was... I'm going to look for it now, because they did a blog post about it, and I think...
Yeah, I kind of want to see that.
In there. Yeah.
But was that it for the for the Chodo set?
I believe so, but with the calendar update, we've got some dates, if y'all are interested.
Actually, real quick on the calendar thing, we can just mention it briefly. Sure. So the calendar pictures and dates did give us pictures of the final Kira Major Mini Plus set.
Because
I just popped in my head. So this is going to be Kira Major Mini Plus set EX. No reason why it can't be set 6, but whatever. So set EX is going to be is going to be Grateful Phoenix, the newest mecha to show up. I mean, it's basically exactly what you'd expect it to be. This is going to be very similar to sets 4 and 5, where you can't buy it in, like, one box where you just get one of each. So you're going to have to get duplicates or split it with a friend or something like that. That will be out towards the end of the month, according to the calendar. And then that will be it for Kira Major Mini Pla. And you can already pre-order the first set of Zenkaiger Mini Pla, which won't be out until next year, on Toe Collectibles right now. They have that already ready to go. So
no idea what it is, but you can pre-order it.
Yeah, no idea what it is.
Yeah.
Right now, it's just a bunch of ovals.
I'm pretty sure they are just ovals with little Japanese text on it.
That's what they are right now. So,
yeah.
For a second, Josh, when you said the last set, I thought you were saying the last Yudo X set, and I was like, already?
Oh.
That would have been sad, but this makes sense.
The last Yudo set's already out right now. So. Yeah.
I did just find the link to some images and the PDF downloads.
Oh, cool.
So I'll have that available in the description down below if anyone else is interested, and I just sent it to you guys to take a look at. They did not call the first... They called, like, one of them a building. The rest are Volcano, Bill A, Bill C, Bill D, Bill E, and Bill F.
Thanks, Bill.
Yeah, thanks, Bill.
Bill
Ding.
So
these are Bill Ding. Yeah. These are really neat. So I think these might scale really well with your Ultraman stuff. So definitely check that out. I'm gonna see right now if the first set came with any.
These will go good with your Shoto Kamen Rider J and your Soto Barlux.
Yeah,
that's right.
And
yeah,
basically that's it.
Man, I forgot that they made a J, because that one was premium. Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
That's unfortunate.
Waiting on you, Shoto X.
Yeah.
For real. Yeah, but as you were saying about the calendar, Corey?
So yeah, we have dates now. So let me pull up. All right.
We briefly were just going to have the news of, hey, they put up a book two, and it's not a complete listing.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. It was very frustrating. We got book two, but Gaim 1, that's due out on November 16th. So 8 days from the time of this recording. Shoto O, November 23rd. So that is 5 days. Wait. 7 days away. 7 day difference.
It's not Monday. It's the
next Monday. I was about to say, you're implying it comes out before the Gaim 1.
November 23rd?
Basically, they that come comes out well the next after two the 16th. Mondays.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was saying 7 days.
Oh, no,
after
wait, I see where you're
what did
at.
I say?
No,
I
you
thought
said
you
it
were
right,
saying
right.
It comes out a week before this podcast comes out or something.
No, No.
I get where you're going.
Yeah, in reference to Gaim.
Yeah,
basically
so
we
November
have...
16th for Gaim, November 23rd for Shoto O.
Yeah.
So that's a 7 day difference between the two.
They come out
releases.
every Monday for the rest of November, starting on the 16th.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, Monday the 16th is Gaim.
Next right. week, book two.
Monday the 23rd is Shoto. Monday the 30th is Soda.
Okay. And, yeah. Hey, if you want to get your Gaim stuff, before everything else, like me, I've pre-ordered Gaim and Shoto O together, so they're gonna ship to me, and I'm gonna sneak book two into the next month.
That's fair.
It never occurred to me until looking at the calendar how far away the Shoto X8 stuff is.
How long is that? Is that like next year?
Yeah, Shoto X11 with X8 and Rider Man is in January, and then the Shoto O Wave with Gem is in March.
Oh, wow, that's March? Wow.
Dang. But, like, also...
Those are each, like, a month later than I thought they would be.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a whiles out, but...
Yeah.
We'll get them eventually. Like, if you're following this line, you must be really patient, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you're at least secure in knowing you get everything, but it'll just take some time. And you know what? That's fine.
Patient, if you're following the blog, you're patient.
Yeah.
Because you're seeing this stuff well
in advance. Speaking of following the blog,
I said you're probably patient if you're following the blog, because you're seeing this stuff way in advance.
It's true.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Speaking of... Hey, let's talk about this hard implementation.
Corey,
I've been asking for this. Exactly, I've been asking for this for months. And I didn't think I'd ever get it.
I really thought when the show was done, I thought our chances were gone for getting these.
Yeah,
same. Absolutely. I don't know why we're getting this, but I'm happy we are. Like,
right?
At least with
Yeah, we still have a bunch of forms
invading horseshoe crab. What?
We still have a bunch of forms to do too, and we're getting this first.
We do, but genuinely, I don't care. This is all I wanted.
Oh no, it's great. I love that we're getting it. I'm just very surprised that we're getting it.
Same. I'm so excited. More army builders, like. I always thought that army builders were tough for Soto to justify. And, you know, we tried sprinkling them throughout the waves, and I guess it worked. I guess that, you know, they sold enough of those to be like, all right, we'll keep doing this. And not only that, we're going to go back to the show before and not even... and bring those into this one.
Not even that. We're going to go back to a movie from a year ago and give you the variant from that one, too.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah,
my God.
I'm looking at the text now. It says, even though this is a mass-produced soldier, we received an unusually large number of questionnaire requests.
I don't know what factors... sort of led to it, but like, it's a cool suit. it's army building. You already got me, but I don't know if that's like a draw for a lot of people. And it's like the only one that used invading horseshoe crabs. So like, sounds cool.
Oh yeah,
right? Like for sure. Invading horseshoe crab. Come on, how do you not want it?
Yeah, but like I'm just like the photos they posted with them next to like the jackal raider and stuff like that. Like yeah, they just look really cool.
Yeah. They also said, and this word implementation, it's nice to have a rugged weapon feeling. It is a very, it's strange to have a little bit more of a realistic looking weapon.
That's true.
Yeah, this looks better than the Guardian weapon.
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah. I don't know if you guys have ever felt this, but like, you know, Sentai Rider, we always have your standard, like, Sentai weapons and stuff, or, right. You know, Toku-looking weapons. But then when someone brings out, like, a real-ass gun, it's like, oh, shit.
It's like when Decade had that gun in Geo for no reason.
Yeah. I was thinking about the time where, like, Durian brought his army friends over and they all had just, like, yeah. Regular AK-47s or whatever the hell. I don't know.
Or like, in the first Gun Gaiden part. Did you watch that, Corey?
No, not yet.
Okay, I will not say anything.
Tonight? Okay.
I was just going to say when Bloodstock killed Taro by flinging a knife at him while he was in the Bloodstock suit.
Oh my god, yeah.
I forgot about that one. Or like Jin when he had that gun and shot the
with it. Oh, regular ass gun.
Yeah.
At least we forget Kuga.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, I guess his gun is technically a regular ass gun.
Yeah.
Well, also Soda made it is the thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, that amazing photo. With Pegasus.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like,
what is this? Aiming for Soto 01, such as a submachine gun Tridenta, whose design seems to be normal in reality, is irresistible. Is that what the name of the gun is called?
Tridenta? I have no idea.
I never heard the name Tridenta before, but that sounds cool.
It does sound cool.
It does, yeah. It might just be some Google Translate jank, so I'll look that up.
Yeah.
I like the picture.
To have a name.
It becomes a picture just by rolling on a part of the company. That's good.
Gotta be honest, I have no idea what you're talking about.
It's like a couple pictures down where they're just sitting on the table.
Oh, okay. You were cutting out a little bit and I wasn't quite sure what you were saying. But yeah, there's like this beautiful looking studio apartment.
I don't really get why this picture's on the here. Desk. But,
oh, yeah. I see. It becomes a picture just by rolling on part of the. I see. Yes. But yeah. Oh man, I'm so excited for these. And like you were saying, it's not just the men, but the women and the children too. No. Oh shoot! I completely forgot. This is an old lady.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah, this is 100% why I wanted this. This is the grandma that I wanted.
I forgot about that.
I finally have her. Oh man.
So,
what a good day.
What's really cool about the fact that they include the battle magia, which first of all, I don't think I knew that that's what they were called in that movie.
Same.
But in the movie they're not used all that much, so to be honest, I didn't even realize like how they were slightly different, but they are.
Yeah. Yeah. If you couldn't tell, or I don't know, if you just wanted us to tell you, the sides of their head, they have the Humagear looking things, and then their pants are just Magear pants but with like modified shins and feeties.
Yeah,
this is so good. I can't believe we have them here. Finally, once again, we get representation for the Remocom brothers, and I couldn't be happier.
Oh, I just realized the thing that he was talking about with the sticker.
What? The Yeah.
He just said, he says something to the effect of, "Now I know your 01 fans are screaming about what's going to be written on the pedestal. We included both names that these are known by."
What is the significance of both of the names? Are there two warring factions for what this name should have been?
I don't have an answer for that, but I can tell you that the official website lists this as Invading Horseshoe Crab Raider, and then in parentheses, Battle Raider. So it had two different names.
So you're going to get three different stand stickers? Total?
Wait, what?
Three. Because wouldn't you also get one for Battle Magia? Or will that be a different figure?
So it's just like, whatever your preference is for the name of this troop builder, you got both stickers.
I appreciate that.
I mean, obviously I'm going with Invading Horseshoe Crab, but now my brain is like, well, you gotta have a version of both.
Oh, well, obviously.
You're right. That makes sense. Well,
live and die by the sticker.
Yes, exactly. What's interesting, though, I believe these are the new stands, and I don't know if the hands are going to fit the ball joint sockets.
Oh. Well, technically, this only comes with two sets of hands, and you can still use the one on the display stand strut. So...
Can you? Because those are sized to the ball joints as well.
Wait, are they? I mean, I'm using them on my existing figures. Like, I'm looking at the Hell Rising Hopper strut right now. I got the hands on there.
No, yeah, that's because they didn't change it for that release.
Did they change the strut for this one?
They didn't change it on the 01 figures in Book 1, but for the Saber figures, they did change it. And now these are the changed ones. I think.
Oh, yeah, I see. Okay, that's going to be interesting.
Yeah, and I mean, like, it's not the first time that they would have done that, because I recently opened my combo change too.
I'm looking at the pedestal now with the two different stickers. The holes for the hands look like they are differently sized from one another.
What do you mean?
Like the right hand peg holes are smaller. That to me suggests that these are like the 01 stands.
Oh, okay, I see. No, I see what you're saying now. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
I was about to say, no way they're going to just, like, forget about the hand storage, right?
Well, you say that, but like I was saying, I open up combo change 2, the hands don't fit.
What?
I think they're the wrong stands.
I need to look into that again. I haven't messed with this for a while.
I remember fiddling with... You know what? I got them right here. You guys talk about something for something, something, something.
Yeah, you were saying, Josh?
I was just going to say, yeah. So these two figures complete the Book 2 lineup. Which will be out on November 30th. I believe that's the final day of the month. So we now have the full wave layout, which is a half 50-50 split 0-1 in Saber. So yeah, because
it's like we've been saying, it's like the show's been saying, it's never over. Their solution this year is not to make one wave and split it between the two figures. It's make two separate waves and pretend that it's one wave.
Pretty much, yeah.
I
believe this is also kind of our best look at how they're splitting up the Jack and the Beanstalk, because we hadn't really seen that.
Which is
as well.
Which is it's split up differently from Brave Dragon, is what I noticed.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a bit of a dick move, but I get it. Like,
yeah, like you have to have both of them. Yeah, unfortunately.
Yeah, we were talking in the Discord with a few people, and they noticed that. And like, at the end of the day, they are a toy company. You sort of get this.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Plus, it's like, one of the things that was brought up was how Kenzan has such light armor that they could probably like package the Three Little Pigs arm in there.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was saying, like, the way that balances out with Buster is his entire sword is probably an arm's worth of plastic.
Oh, that's true. I didn't think about how big that's going to be when they make it.
But also, you know, Saber used Three Little Pigs, so you're going to have to make a Saber figure with the Three Little Pigs.
I did also bring that up, how, like, oh, that's going to be really difficult for them to do, because guess what? When Kenzan uses it, it doesn't have shoulder armor.
Saber
uses it, it does.
I'm curious what they'll do eventually, because, like, are they just going to keep re-releasing the Brave Dragon half of the suit, like they did here?
I don't know. Like an hour before the blog news dropped, I was saying that the episode that aired that day had the debut of the Crimson Dragon, I think is the name of the all red combo.
Yeah, Crimson Dragon.
And I was saying that seems
I was lied to! I was told that they were units! And it was incorrect. What the hell is a Wonder Unit?
Yeah, because you have Fantastic Lion, I believe is the name of his all three form. And then you have Crimson Dragon. And yep, I definitely don't remember what a spot is. It's called
Golden Alangina.
Ah, okay, perfect.
Good. But what I was saying was that
I didn't. That's strange name. I was still reeling from like, what does that mean? Golden Angelina Jolie.
Hansel Nuts. Anyway, I was saying that
to Greg.
Book 2 is where we get rid of the box sets, so this kind of isn't really important, but, you know, usually the box sets would have their main figure that they would put up front, and usually it's going to be the main character. So I thought, it would make sense that they would maybe have Book 2 have the all-red combo up front. But nope.
Yeah, I mean, regardless, we are now
at the point where the show has introduced two of those full color combos, so they can start introducing those into the line. Maybe have Book 3 be Crimson Dragon, Book 4 maybe has the second one, the Fantastic one. Or Book 3 could have both
first,
of those.
But sure. I would like both at once, but...
Yeah, I was about to say, like, based on the way they handled Espada, maybe they could just have, like, Saber and Blades in Book 3, and then Book 4 is where you get Espada.
Possibly.
Gotta have that one that's just like, if you want to have the full set, you gotta get the next wave.
I'm curious how they're gonna do it with, because I know we've talked about how they'll probably just make the arms when they do the full combos, but there were a couple of times when Saber used books that were not part of his full combination. They were part of Blades and Espadas, where his helmet changed specifically.
Yeah.
So we're going to need to get the helmet somehow, because the arm would be the same between the two forms, but the head would be different. So they could just pack a bunch of random Saber heads in with those arms, but, you know.
It might just be like an end of the year thing.
I don't know if it'll take that long.
But, I don't think so either, yeah. But, it depends on how long they stretch out 01, I think, because that's taking up slots, so...
Yeah.
I was also going to say, you could just handle it like Bill did with the Hazard forms, where it's just like, this random figure comes with the head for Dragon Peter.
Yeah, that's true. I could see that happening that way, too.
Like, you could, like, whenever we do... how different is Three Little Pigs between Saber's and Kenzan's version?
Well, Buster and Kenzan's basically arms, yeah. It's just like how Buster is with Jack and the Beanstalk. They basically just don't have the shoulder.
The RKF
but, like,
line...
It also, for the three different clones of Kenzan, he had the three different houses. So, like, Do you think the houses will be spread out?
I didn't even think about that.
I can imagine those just being like swappable pieces, maybe spread out, like you said.
Actually, to be honest with you, I didn't even notice that he had three different houses when he went into the three.
I would also like the cardboard cutouts. Oh, this is where the paper craft comes back in. I'd like the cardboard cutouts of each of the three little pigs, please.
Yes, thank you. Yes, there you go.
They
could be like the series logos for that they put in those clear stands.
Yeah.
What was I going to say? I was talking about how RKF handled these. Because what they did was just, like, swap it out at the bicep. There's, like, a peg there. Soto can do that. It's just I sometimes question, are they seeing some of those pegs as, like, viable to swap out? Like, Kuga did that with Pegasus form, but Chronicle is also, like, a slightly older audience, so maybe that's why they were okay with it. I don't know.
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah, because, like, it's not just that they skew younger here, but it's, like, it's not typically advertised as something to customize with either. Mm-hmm. So, like, maybe they shy away from that.
I mean,
I am wondering.
I even, during 01, was saying that, oh, how are they going to handle Lightning Hornet? Because it has alternate feet. They don't really do, like, swappable ball joint feet, do they? And then they did.
Yeah, they did. It took a while, but they did.
I feel like that's just because they've never had a use.
Well, I also love the idea of, like, you know, they end the series and they kind of look back and they're like, what little small things that we never did can we go back and do?
Yeah.
And they would have to do that with Saber, with the middle portion, because alternate shins, alternate feet.
Yeah. It's true.
Yeah.
So
it's gonna be interesting. At least Dragon Jack-kun shows us that they're not limiting themselves to how they split Brave Dragon. They're willing to, like, mix things around.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
But
also with Brave Dragon, someone did bring up in the Discord. Let me see the conversation.
It was something about the chest, right?
Yeah, something about the chest, like it not lining up. And it took me a bit, but I finally understood what they were saying.
Yep. Saber's middle portion has, like, a little chunk cut out of it.
Yeah. Her name, and these are her words, not mine, Brainless Girl, noted that chest chunk has, like, a little cutout in the... his right, our left.
Yeah,
of his chest chunk that Espada doesn't have, to accommodate for Brave Dragon's thing, and, like, we were able to swap it in for Blades because Blades' whole chest just sandwiched on top of it, so they could kind of get away with it. Espada, however, cannot. So I don't know. I don't know if it will be compatible, but, like,
compatible.
I'm not too broken up if it is or isn't. I'm just happy that there is a more
good
looking sculpt.
The whole gimmick of swapping them to make, like, stuff that wasn't on the show is neat, but as long as they can do all the things that they need to do from the show, then it doesn't bother me.
Yeah. And I mean, like, I do wonder, once we do get the triple color versions, or the three of the same color versions, if Saber might have a revised dragon part to be more swappable with everyone else.
Maybe, but I'm
even doubting what I'm saying here.
I'm
just saying it could be a possibility. Yeah, full wave layout.
Yeah.
Good shit.
Just to recap, since it has been a while, the Saber figures are, well, clearly the Brave Jakun that we've been talking about. Then Espada and Calibur. And then from 01, you get Naki. And then the two new figures you talked about with the Battle Raider and the Battle Magia. So.
Yeah. Again, yeah. I'm really impressed that we got this.
Absolutely, yes.
Because, like,
I'm blown away. Like, even, I can I can even... quit Soto now. This is all
I want.
even during 0-1, even during 0-1, we were just, or at least I was, just like trying to figure out how the Bottle Raider Battle Magia could be split between three boxes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, I guess the solution is, no, there's just two figures.
I like the idea of Corey collecting Soto for 4 years, and the story just stops. He got everything he needed.
Yeah, yeah, it's because the Battle Raider. I finally got my grandma to save these children. So, but like, let's talk about this wave, because for a while we've been thinking like, you know, maybe something's screwy with this. Maybe something. I don't know. Maybe. Like this looks like a very confident wave.
Yeah.
And it feels like it maybe had to have been planned so far in advance, just because this number of 12 lines up so well with just the number of boxes we get in a box.
When do you think this would have been conceived? Like 6 months, maybe?
I don't know.
Yeah, I think
it's I wonder if this was a result of, oh, this pandemic thing is starting to happen. Maybe we should plan ahead.
Maybe.
I don't know.
I don't know. Because, like, this, once again, this was moved back a month. Hmm. And we, you know, obviously we'll never know why. That's completely fine. It's just... it's interesting. I wonder what set it back, because everything we have here, I think we've seen these three episodes in, and we've seen everything we see here, maybe. When did Espada debut?
Episode three? I think it was episode 4 or 5.
I think
I think his character was in episode like two or three. Yeah.
Two or three.
Yeah. Okay. Alright.
Regardless.
But yeah. We've known about all of these for a while, mm-hmm. and typically Soto is behind. So this comes as no surprise.
Well, yeah, I mean, typically they're behind, but usually they get behind a little later on than this.
I don't know, because like we started early. That's why I feel like maybe we feel a little bit more behind.
They start early.
Potentially. Mm-hmm. Huh?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they...
yeah.
They made
maybe
it a selling
like a
point.
Week early.
Oh, I guess that's true.
They made a sell point of, this is the earliest we've debuted Soto this year.
Yeah. And, you know, metatextually, it's like... Everyone also can only ship this through DHL, so we've gotten it the fastest that we've ever gotten it before.
Mm-hmm.
On top of us being early.
That's fair, yeah.
So, I don't know.
But, so, I mean, I feel like what the selection of 0-1 characters in Book 2 is, I think it's basically a guarantee that Book 3 will also have 0-1 characters in it.
Maybe. I mean, what do we want to say in terms of what we not what we guarantee, but what we hope is a staple here, because I'm bringing up the Ami Ami listing right now. I want to see how many is in a full box
of three. Yeah so set three would be December.
The other day I typed in Ami Ami into Ami Ami for some reason, and
nice.
I don't know why. Yeah.
It just opens the site.
They've got
the
Ami
site.
Ami exclusive items, actually, so that's neat for them.
Hmm.
Let's see. Book 3, yeah, Book 3 is another 12-pack. Do we think we're filling up an entire book, or an entire box?
Honestly, I'm going to say yeah.
Yeah? Yeah?
I think so.
do we want to make low-stakes bets now?
Wait. Did, when Ami Ami says that, did they say something in the description like, a box of 12 of 8 types or something?
Assorted according to the maker's rate from 12 types.
Wow. Okay.
I think
so...
I think it's 12 new.
Okay. Cool.
So that might be a staple. Yeah. Like, they said, hey, we're not doing box, or we're not doing sets anymore, complete sets anymore. But we are just gonna make them big. We're just gonna make big. I forgot who it was. Either Peacemaker or Blade Raider had predicted way early on that it would have been just filling out the entire 12 pack. Mm-hmm. I'm curious about 4, 5, and 6.
I didn't think that they would do that, so.
Here's a question about the combinations.
Yeah.
Because we've talked about how, like, wonder if they'll, like, put more than one in one box. My thought, looking at Dragon Jakun, is that's split between two boxes, but that's also not a lot of new tooling. So I wonder if potentially there would be like, there's so much new tooling here that we're going to have to split it more than like two boxes. I don't know.
But like, here's the thing. With Saber and Espada, I feel like they're trying to make their money back on the really intricate main rider mold. So part of me thinks we're going to be getting regular Sabers just... next time with
Arthur.
Yeah, maybe Arthur, but I was also thinking Three Little Pigs. Just whatever else we've seen solo and or part of.
If they don't want to go too far ahead and make the all red combo, then it would actually make sense to do, like, the one with the three little pigs, because that had Eagle in the middle. So you get Eagle out of the way.
It's true.
Well, okay, so then they could re-release Eagle later as well.
Well, what it means is that they, I don't really know what the name of the last red combo is, but it's based on Journey to the West.
Yeah, Sayo Journey.
Basically, I'm saying that they can just, like, release that part of the body later. And just for now, get out Eagle and Three Little Pigs.
But I feel like the way this is sort of working is, like, we are still going to get re-releases. But they can't just not release it as one figure. Because, like you were saying, that has to be the big thing at the front of the box. Well,
yeah.
They don't do hypothetical front of the box anymore. They're not sets, so...
Yeah, exactly. That's why I said it's kind of a moot point to bring that up, but also I can imagine, at least with the promo material, they would want to have, like, a figure up front.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think this is their way to get Saber at least once each time. Just pair it with something new.
Oh, yeah.
And if the next wave, we're going to do something similar, like I said, Soto never sets a precedent. So...
Yeah.
Based what? Off of this, huh?
I was about to say, no, the saying is, Soto makes the precedent.
Does it? Because, like, I feel like every wave we get surprised. The precedent is surprise every time. You never know what you're going to get.
Yeah, like, that's Soto to me. You don't know what you're going to get.
I guess so, yeah. So it is going to be strange... saying, like, hey, what do we think is happening for book two based off of these guidelines, because honestly we don't know, but I think it's a neat exercise anyway. I'm thinking if they're still going chronologically, we're getting Saber Arthur, we're getting Blue Boy, three of them together in a book.
Fantastic
the
Lion,
three books. That's Fantastic Lion is what I said. And then Buster. Like, that would be your three Saber figures. And then the rest of it, I'm thinking, when's the movie going to be out?
The Saber Zero One movies? They come out December 18th.
If they knew about all the movie stuff, huh?
They come out December 18th in Japan.
Oh, okay. Okay. If they're out in time, then maybe it'd be interesting to put in the movie people.
Oh, yeah, the new two of the movie Abandon people. Or whatever they were called. Yeah.
Yeah.
Abaddon?
Yeah, Abaddon. There we go. Yeah.
That was another one that came up in the Discord, because he was like, I'm really interested to see what Soto does with those four, because that seems like a real challenge to release.
Yeah. Well, AI 13.
Yeah.
I was saying it's such a challenge, I kind of wouldn't be surprised if they had to be like, we're releasing two of these guys now, and then two in the next wave.
I'd be perfectly fine with that.
Yeah.
But then maybe that last one, the last figure in there. You know what? Troop Builder. What do we not have? What are we missing? Oh, you know what? No. We're gonna get not Ikazuchi, but you know, Birdman, you turn him into a Magir.
The Dodo Magir?
Dodo Magir version 2.
Yeah, the one that they didn't make. Yes.
Yeah. And it'll come with Ikazuchi's better crotch.
Exactly.
Yes. Or maybe just Ikazuchi.
He just comes again.
Yeah. I mean, we got Saber, he came again.
That's true.
Yeah.
I don't know. We won't be done until we get Realizing Hopper. We need Realizing Hopper.
Yeah. Josh, I recognize you might need to depart soon.
Probably soon, yes.
Okay. Did you want to stay for Gaim, or did you want to head out, and then we could just do Gaim?
We can do Gaim real quick.
All right, let's do some Gaim real quick, because this is basically everything we knew about already.
Yeah, I had the same moment here that I had last night, where I was like, oh, right, talk of Saber and 01, there's also Gaim stuff.
Yeah.
Like you said, nothing we didn't really know before. It just kind of seemed a good.
What is that loincloth situation? I just noticed it.
So the loincloth, if you've guys gotten your hands on Yudo X2, the loincloth on.
Garza?
Big man, horse face.
Garza.
Evil. Garza, yes. He has a skirt piece that potentially could be similar, mm-hmm. because his actually swivels on that axis, mm. and then also flaps up.
Mm.
Like, that is such a tiny peg, and I feel like, once again, if the baby toy line could do it, maybe yes. That's what I'm hoping, at least. But it does look like, you know, obviously a separate part. Which is good, because that means if you wanted to do customs, you could just take this belt off and put it on a different rider, and then cut out the faceplate and put on your other faceplate. You'd be good to go.
Oh, yeah.
Off their face, yes. Okay.
If you wanted to do a little...
I'm definitely doing...
If you wanted to do a little sticker microsurgery.
I'm doing some sticker microsurgeries on things here, for sure.
Hell yeah.
I already know for sure that I'm... since they're not gonna offer it, I'll be making custom stickers for the eyes.
Hmm.
So.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet, but I'm definitely going to do that. And when I do, I'll make sure to share it with the Discord and on Twitter. So.
Nice.
Hell yeah.
Share your process too.
But yeah. Hey, speaking of.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I will.
Speaking of eye stickers, you know, let's cover them both at the same time. Both Zangetsu and Grape Man Boy Dude.
Ryugen.
Ryugen has both the eye stickers. What did I say? And that's exactly what I thought I said.
Oh, yeah, clearly.
Yeah. They have the empty eye stickers when you don't have fruit on them. So that's neat. Even Ryugen has like the little extra gold stripe on his chest to still fill that out.
Yeah, that's a neat detail. I like that.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, extra mile on all these figures.
Oh, for sure.
He's got the little S shapes on his shoulder pads. You've got a gun. If you use the sword hand, you can make him pretend he's being John Wick. The bent sword hand, the forward bent sword hand, so that's cool. Zangetsu, he's the one I really want to talk about. because, man, those melon grains are incredible. I can't get over them. Like, I keep bringing this up every time Zangetsu shows up, but the arms action figure, if you've seen it, like, they tried to do a grain pattern in there. They, you know, it was respectable for the time.
Yeah.
But it was like, have you ever looked at, like, a wall with, like, some grains on it for, like, noise dampening or whatever?
Yeah.
It's kind of like that. So it's incredible how far we've come. His Musou saber does have his crest on it, so it is accurate.
Yeah, I like that detail.
Love to see.
Yeah.
That'd be a cool thing for this, for if they ever do a CSM Musou saber, to have a swappable plate there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that'd be neat. And then also the Melon Defender has two pegs. One of them is for the shield connector, and I guess the other one could be too.
Well, yeah,
I don't know if that's 3 mil.
It's for, like, having him hold it two different ways.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was for the display stand.
They're just showing that it can work with that.
It could be for both.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's mainly so he can have it, like, kind of used as, like, a whole arm guard or holding it, like, forward.
Yeah.
Interesting. I'm failing to see the difference between the images, but I'll take your word on it. I don't care that much.
I don't know exactly how to describe it, but one of the... Yeah, you...
Man, there's a decent... Josh is going full robot, and I wish I could hear him.
Oh, great.
He's okay now.
Yeah, sorry, man. But hey, don't worry. We're almost done. Just as Josh wants to do, you can do the form changes, and they're not the most successful.
Yeah, it's very unfortunate.
But you can do them. Yeah.
The worst part about it to me, besides the fact that the eye stickers that they don't give you, and the belt stickers too, not being accurate, but you could kind of surgery that, is the fact that on Budo Arms Zangetsu, you have all of that green left over from Ryugen.
Yep.
Yeah. It's a mess. But hey, you know what? It's just fun. You can do it for fun. It's not.
Good
I enough. Mean.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Melon Arms Ryugen. Those that looks good. But it's just.
Yeah.
It's
I mean, that's because Ryugen is blocking the white from view with the defender.
I guess that's true.
So if you've
yeah.
got that, yeah.
It's true. It's just unfortunate that since these two arm swaps actually happened in the Hyper Battle DVD, it was a bit of a shame that they didn't try to make them a little more accurate, but at least you can do it, you just have to work with it a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I can't wait to see what else comes from Soto Gaim. It's gonna be a good time.
Absolutely.
Speaking of Chronicle, though, oh, shoot. Yeah, it's already over. The Endiguava Zebra, he is done at Premium Bandai. Mm-hmm. Pre-orders are closed. Next week, we will be talking about Soto Saber. Well, as early as next week, we're talking about Soto Saber Book 3.
Finally,
yeah.
It feels this gap between wave one and wave two feels like during 01 when the things got delayed the first time. It feels like such a long wait.
Yeah, that's fine. It's like, hopefully, around December-ish when you get more Christmas money or something, then you'll just have more to spend on
this.
That's what I'm holding out hope for. Yeah.
Cool.
Hey, we are steadily approaching an hour. Josh has to go soon, so I think maybe now is a good time to end off, huh? Mm-hmm. What do you say?
That sounds good to me.
Good episode.
All right. Awesome. So everyone, thank you so much for listening. We are fully back this week, so there was an episode of Soda Pop News. if you haven't gotten your fill from this already. And then hopefully, I don't know, man, our weekend content, that'll just be whenever we feel like it. I think I've expressed this on multiple occasions. It's whenever we feel like it, yeah. Whenever we hopefully get them out. You know, we just want to, I got burnt out, so I don't want that to happen again. It's going to be a little bit lower energy for those, but you're still getting your news. You're still getting the podcast episodes and then some extra stuff on top of that. And who wouldn't want that?
Yeah.
Speaking of extra stuff, Josh, you know where to find this guy. He talks about Lightning Collection nonstop on his channel, Toku Topics. We've got Malunas over here doing tons of articles on the Tokusatsu Network. Mm-hmm. And, you know, find us all on Twitter. Links are in the description down below.
Got Discord.
Discord. Yes, head on yes. In there. We talk in there quite often. I think, Malunas, you're a bit more... You're the one that's more active there, but I hop in every now and again.
I got nowhere to be.
Josh doesn't... Yeah, Josh does not exist on that Discord, apparently. So yeah.
He contributed bad. Once. I remember once he contributed in the Kamen Rider topic, I think.
That's true.
I was like, oh, Josh, what are you doing
Discord
here?
Is just... Yeah. Discord's just not my, but yeah. Not my social media. It's just not...
No, that's fair. Completely fair. So find us all on Twitter, because that's where... most of us are at, I guess. And then also, I am on over on Go Mango. We do watch alongs and reviews of every week of Toku, so like consistently, and we're past 800 subscribers, so we're 200 away from 1,000 and being able to monetize. So maybe help us out. Yeah, so head on over there.
Movement.
Do you guys have anything else? Huh?
I said Black Lives Matters movement in the description.
Yes, yes. Always in there. I also believe the partnership, the sponsorship we had with the voting thing ended because
the election ended.
We don't need to vote anymore. We did that. Yeah, we're done. We did it. Good job, everybody. But also, once again, like I said last week, if you didn't vote and you could have, absolutely fuck you. But hey, if not, then congratulations, you voted. Yeah, if you guys don't have any other things to plug, I think that's a good enough spot to end.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, so guys, thank you so much for listening. Keep it.
See ya.
Middle, go in. Oh, I could have opened this episode by going, Watashi da. Anyway, thanks for listening.
Hard, 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 hard!
That's how we end.